I'm Jeff Bradshaw with Redneck Restorations. This old truck brought to you by ElderlyIron.com. I've got issues. Well, we're trying to get in full swing with Project Whitey again. One of the things I wanted to do was clean all the paint off the passenger door. So I thought I'd try some paint stripper and some different blast media and kind of show you how it goes. Well, one thing I wanted to do is use my pressure washer, but I couldn't find the hose. So I went to looking for it and found it underneath the tire of this water truck here. And that's because I had it out here and was doing some work and then left it set beside the water truck. And one day I had to move the water truck over a little bit so I could get something out from behind it. And then I parked it back right on top of my pressure washer hose, which is right over here.
Right there, which presents a problem.
Well, not that the problem really that it's parked on top of the hose, but the problem is it's only about 38 degrees. Now, in a previous video, when I started up this truck, there's a couple of commenters that said that they'd never buy an engine from me if I used that much ether to start it. Well, number one, you didn't read what I put in the description, and number two, you didn't listen to what I said in the video. This engine has a lot of miles. It's got low compression. It does not start easy. It will not start at 38 degrees unless you use ether. Now, being that it's a diesel and the diesel runs off the heat of compression, I kind of got to thinking that maybe if I made a heater to heat up the air that's going in the engine, that'll work. So, let's test that theory. This is the heating element out of an electric dryer. Now, since I do a fair bit of scrapping whenever I get an electric dryer, I tend to take these out and keep them. For what? Well, take the screw out, you can pull the heating element out of it. Looks like this. Okay, if you want to see it in here, there it is, okay? So, if you were to stick this in a bench vise, and then hook a battery charger to it, you'll find out if you put it across these two terminals that you're not going to get hardly anything at all. Because this is made for 220 volts. And the amount of amperage that you can push through this heating element at 220 volts is sufficient to heat the element. However, when you're dealing with 12 volts, because that truck is 12 volt and not a 24, then the resistance offered by the heating element is too much for the 12 volts to overcome, and it's not going to heat up for you. So here's what you got to do. Well, with my handy dandy 200 boost amp battery charger, right now it's set on 10 amps. If you stick this across here, at 10 amps, nothing. This is one continuous coil through here. So what you can do is you can bypass some of the coils. If we go like that and drop it on the ground, we don't get anywhere. I'm heating up one half of it now. Well, maybe. Eh, warm. But I can only supply 10 amps. If I bump it up to 40, I can feel it. Bump up to 80. Yeah, that's getting warm. We'll go with our 200 amp boost. Give it a couple seconds here. Well, not too hot to put your hand on. But it's warming up. It's getting hotter as we go here. Okay, so if I move it over one, that's definitely getting hot. I can feel the heat off of it here now. Now I can see the little waves of heat coming up off of it. Oh yeah, that's putting out some heat. So here's what we're going to do.
So what you're looking at here on this dryer element, your two terminals here, that's one continuous long element. It just starts from that wire and goes down, back up and down, around and over around the other side and back in. But what we can do we can come right across the top of these with a wire, and across the top of these with a wire, and the same thing down at the bottom, come across all three of those on each side with a wire, and then what we will have done is hook them up in parallel, which means we're going to put 12 volts through each individual length of coil there. Let's give it a try, shall we?
I started making a coil out of electric fence wire. Works pretty well. Doesn't offer any resistance. Heats right up. But what I'm going to do here, I'm going to make a loop that comes around both sides. Uh-oh, lost my cutters. Here they are. This is only for experiment. I don't imagine that I'm going to make really good contact. Now we can apply some voltage. Applying. I don't recommend dead shorts for your battery charger. And this is not a dead short because these elements do have resistance to them. A straight coil of wire, however, does not. I put it back to 10 amps. It's pulling it down pretty good. We got heat. Oh yeah, we got heat. Nice heat. Oh, quit it. Hey, let's bump it up. Why, it's glowing. Woo! Works. Hey, Acme 66, you ought to like that pretty good, huh? Melted her off there, it did. I'll bet if I clip it on the bottom, or it wasn't pulling the wire over, it's just hanging down there, I bet it worked a lot better. Let's try that. Boom! Pulling her down. Worked 40 amps. Yeah, that puts a pretty good heat off of there. This is just an experiment. Doesn't mean I'm going to use this kind of wire. You need to rate your wire at how much current carrying capability it has. So I'm probably going to be using a, probably 6 gauge wire to come across and connect these. Oh yeah.
See that glow? It's a healthy glow.
Well, okay, the weather went and turned cold on me, and gonna dress up a little bit. Made myself some bus bars. Now, that's not the liquor cabinet on your motorhome. It's a metal strip that you put electrical contacts to. So, we are going to install the bus bars onto our heating element. Wondering why I'm using Allen head screws, that's because I had some. I had some of this here 6 gauge wire left over from another project. So let's see which is top. That's the top.
Now, if this is going to fail, the circuit that is, any place it's going to heat up, it'll be right here at these connectors. Doesn't matter which one's positive or negative. It's a heating element. It doesn't care. Power up. We'll start at 40 amps. Woo! What'd we hit? Ground to something else. There's heat coming off of it. All six of them. Let's buff it up. Six gauge wire is never going to get hot. Ah, working nicely. It's cold today. It's staying about 30, 32. Got great big snowflakes falling right now. Well, that's creating a little breeze coming off of there. Let's go to 200. Oh yeah. Next part of the experiment, stick it inside the housing. Oh, I like this. Now, this wire is awfully stiff. I'm gonna have to secure this somehow. I can do it without grounding something out here. It's just an experiment, don't get excited. Not gonna start a fire. Okay, I might start a fire. But still nothing gets caught. Set the camera in such a way, if you look right here at this edge, there's that shelf behind there, and maybe you can see the heat coming out of it. The rippling of the airwaves. That's on 40 amps. Boosting! Now we're on 200. Cobwebs inside flipping around. I know it's moving air. Ah. I like that. Yes. My hands are cold. I think you can't see it.
I can't see nothing there except that little piece of cobweb right there.
Well, what remains now is the battery test, and that's to take my 1,000 volt crank amp batteries. The truck's supposed to have two of them in there. So I'll get one fully up to charge, hook it up to here, and see what kind of amperage it draws. And hopefully it'll do better than this charger. Feels good. I think I'll get more. Okay, so that turns our one heating element into six heating elements. Take three. Well, that blur and fog you see there is some condensation on the inside of the camera. That ought to be wonderful. Well, the fog is up gone. Well, the fog is gone off the camera lens. This is a good thing. You have to make me a 12 volt tester.
But it's not getting any brighter, which is good. That means we can bump our amperage up. Here, I guess I'll let you watch what happens.
Pumping 200 amp boost.
Why it doesn't seem to glow anymore?
Hard to do with gloves on. I'm not dead again.
There's them big old snowflakes.
Well, what remains now is the battery test.
Why? It's glowing! Woo! Woo!
Let's make contact with metal frame and what happened. Because this is hanging on here and make contact with frame there. And this one hanging here make contact with the frame there. It dead shorted. And that's why I say I don't recommend dead shorting things. You know what I could do is I could just flip it right on here and it'll do the same thing.